Hello everyone, and welcome to the 9 a.m. session in the Research and Education track. As a reminder to our in-world and web audience, you can view the full conference schedule at conference.opensimulator.org and tweet your questions or comments to at OpenSimCC with the hashtag OSCC14 exclamation mark. This hour, we are happy to introduce a terrific session called Unicam Earth Island, OpenSim in Geoscience Education. Our speakers today are Annalisa Boniello and Eleonora Paris. Annalisa Boniello is a high school natural science teacher and a PhD candidate in Teaching Earth Science at University of Camerino, Unicam, with a thesis on the use of virtual worlds in geoscience education, geological hazards. She has a master's degree in e-learning at University of Florence, Italy, and a master's degree in metacognitive learning at IUL Italian University Online. Eleonora Paris is an associate professor at University of Camerino. Dr. Paris is a geologist interested in geoscience education and founded EarthNet, a national network of institutions and schools for increasing awareness on geoscience education.
Thank you very much for your nice introduction. I'm Eleonora Paris, and I will start introducing this project, which is actually Annalisa's project for PhD, and she will talk in details later on in the next slides. Just I would like to start talking about what is the purpose, why we started this project. The main reason is that Italy, as well as are becoming much more fragile than before due to geological hazards and the effects of these hazards on the territory. Not only on the territory, but also in the risk that are affecting the population. And in Italy, it's also for affecting the cultural heritage. So all these events, natural events, are natural and they cannot be in any way, you can avoid them. But what is possible to do is try to prevent the negative effects and at least mitigate them. So for making very good prevention and mitigate this effect, the effect of the geological hazards, it's important to increase the knowledge of the territory where people live in, to increase the awareness of hazards that are in the territories, and to increase the practice of civil protection. The problem is how to make that, and the key, I think, is for the education in school and education of the citizens and the education of the people and the future citizens. This is important because education in school will help to increase the knowledge of natural phenomena and have a better understanding. And we expect that the better understanding will improve also the knowledge of the area and the risk that can affect the area where you live, and increase also the attention for the environment and awareness for the protection of the environment itself. So the idea is that we create a group that is dealing with these topics, putting together teachers, high school teacher or middle school teacher in science, and people from university which are dealing with geology and environment. And the idea is to create an experiment, a new methods and approach to teach our science, new way to support the schools and to support the teachers in this way. What is important is to find new ways to attract the attention of the students on these topics. And in this way, we tried to experiment new ways. So the project we presented to geoscience for what we know about, and especially due for geoscience education in Italy. And we present some of the experience that Annalisa is promoting in her area, and I would like to focus the attention that Annalisa is coming from Napoli area. This is one of the most important and most dynamic areas in the world. So she will go on talking about our project together, and I'll pass the presentation to Annalisa now. Please.
Thank you, Eleonora. I am Annalisa Boniello. I am a science teacher, and in my doctoral research, I start from actual context. And this actual context is that our study students have changed radically. And they use educational virtual games, they know or use simulation environment or virtual environment, Minecraft, World of Warcraft, and other virtual environment. So these students need to be motivated in different ways. And we can use immersive methodologies that produce an improvement in cognitive and perceptual dynamics. This is the start point of my project. And another part of my starting point is the actual context for game-based learning and student in Italy. Because in Italy, the result of my research is this. 84% of secondary students of grade 1 and 2 use virtual games and use educational games, and 60% know or use simulation environment. As Minecraft, World of Warcraft, Wii, PlayStation, Xbox, but what is the situation for science teacher in Italy? The actual context is that about the topic of game-based learning is that in Italy 70% of science teacher don't use the serious game, or 50% don't know serious game or virtual worlds. And so is a difference between there is a very good difference between the student and the teacher in Italy. So my aim is to spread innovation in the school in Italy, and innovation in the teaching of science teacher in Italy. But why using games to science learning? And these are sentences that on which I based my work. The game is the preferred way to the brain to learn things, who make the distinction between education and entertainment don't know the first of two, and the culture in its original phases bears the character of a game. And but the students know this situation, but the science teacher and the teacher don't know this sentence. So in my workshop with the teacher, together the students, I talk about the use of the serious game in the virtual environment. But what is a serious game? A serious game is a game in which education is the primary goal rather than entertainment. And this is very important for a good way for a good teaching in geoscience education. And the positive aspect of the digital game-based learning is promotes motivation, the challenge increase during the game, promotes learning by doing, promotes active learning and problem-solving skills. I talk in every workshop with the teacher and with the students about this. For improve the motivation to learn with the innovative environment, with this innovative environment in the classroom. So, another question of the teacher is, science teacher is real or and virtual in the classroom? What is the good way? Good learning in science education is, I think, that together real and virtual are a good way, are a right way for science education. So I will show you two slides that effectiveness of these learning games in education, because pedagogy, computer science, and games work together, and learning games simulation to create game-based learning. And another slide is that about the motivation. The motivation improved, but from this way on with the virtual environment and serious game. Another in this slide, I will talk about the word of Jessica Tribus. Jessica Tribus work on and compare the traditional training, hands-on training, and game-based learning training, and say that the game-based learning is cost-effective, has low physical risk liability, and highly engaging for students, and the student can easily transfer learning to this environment. But not the same for traditional training and hands-on training. In the bottom of a cone of learning, where we tend to remember our level of involvement. In fact, in the bottom of this cone of learning, there is during a dramatic presentation real experience, and this is in environment. In the Unicam Island, we work with a virtual environment, and the research is focused on increased knowledge and awareness of natural phenomena in potentially dangerous area, experimenting learning paths for teaching earth science using movie, involving school of the area of Florian Fields area, and introducing the science teacher to a new approach. These are the four. So the project includes are educated and studied, and the student role playing steps or tests, solving various questions placed on the path and acquire scientific skill. In this process, science teachers are involved. What is the area? The area is a volcanic area near Vesuvius in the south of Italy and Flegrean Fields. In this area, there is a high risk, and we work on the civil protection, and so science use game in Unica is built with simulations, try to reproduce the experience as real to prepare. In which the students as a little scientist, little geologist, that they can study the area, the volcanic area. And in this game, the participants assume the roles of the characters in a fictional setting, or multiplayer or single player, because the student can work as a single player or in multiplayer environment. aim is the debriefing. What is the debriefing? The debriefing is when participants make connection between experience in the game and experience in real life. And the debriefing is focuses on what the participant may have learned from playing the game. For example, with a visit to a volcanic area. This is Unica Mert Island. And in this Unica Mert Island, I have used a role play for every part, inquiry-based science education, problem solving to improve creativity, collaboration, cooperation between students and between teachers and students. And also between teachers and teachers. Where are real scientific context, activities for authentic evaluation to improve attention and motivation for students and for teachers. So this is the map. In the map of island, volcanoes, path, flagrant fields, path, and geology and paleontology camp. But there are other paths on as a geology management. The scientific activity in every path are tsunami, a simulation of tsunami, on minerals and rocks, simulation of eruptions, and inquiry-based science activities. The student solve questions, answer questions, volcano, for example. The path. I show you the path on volcanoes. In every part of the island, there are tests and post-testing Google Drive, and the link is in the inward on a prim. There is a sheet with for every student, question in the path, simulation of eruption or simulation of magmatic rocks. This is the first step of the path, the test, the pre-test. Now the path. The path has seven steps. In the first step, there are volcanoes in the world, distribution of volcanoes. In this first step, there are text, interactive object, question, image, simulation. And the volcanoes is Phlegrean Fields Volcanoes, a classification of volcanoes, or Vesuvius. There are simulation eruption on the ground and the sea. In the second step of the path, the students can go into inside the earth. And there are every part of this earth, mantle, nucleus, crust, and they can explore the inside of the earth. Then click on object, there are interaction with the object, and they can go in the third step. In the third step, there are the question, what is volcano. And there is a classification of volcanoes, Pelian volcanoes, Islandis volcanoes, Hawaiian volcanoes, and there is in every step an help for students. So the student can write in chat help, the word help, and creates a single object, a red object with other instruction, with other information on the path. In the step number four, there are the question, what do you know rocks and minerals? There are animation on minerals, on silicate, on magmatic rocks, and they can explore every part of the project. There are rock of magmatic rock, for example, basalt, and they can click on every rock to get data or information, and to solve the question or test. In the step number five, there is a simulation of a secondary volcanism. We can see gas emission in the solfatare area. The solfatare area is an area near Naples, where is the Phlegrean fields, and there are emissions of water, hot water or other. So the student can click on object in this area, and they can walk near other part of this path, where is the temple of Serapide. The temple in this part, there is a reconstruction of the temple of Serapide. This temple is in the Phlegrean fields, and this temple showed the phenomenon of bradycism. And the bradycism is when there are earthquakes, because Earth has a periodic rise and fall, because this area is a volcanic area. And on the column of this temple, there are little animals that eat the stones when the temple. The step number six, the student can go into the volcano. Inside the volcano, they can collect data, scientific data, and this is in this part there is an inquiry-based science education activity. They collect data, they analyze rocks around the volcano, so they can answer in chat the solution. And when they answer the right answer, there is a prism, a red prism that show them that this is the right answer. The target of research are Neapoli students in 10 schools in the Phlegrean fields and 500 the students of secondary school of first and second grade, and 70 science teachers of this area. But this Unicamert Island, this path on volcanic area is open opened for all teachers, all science teachers in Italy and in the world. To project this path, I have used the principle of Paul G for a good learning in digital games. The principle for me are four, very important. Subset principle, the learning first occurs in a simplified subset of the real domain. Active critical learning principle, when every aspect of the learning environment should be set up to encourage active and critical learning. And probing principle, we learn by engaging with the world, reflecting on our actions, forming hypotheses, reprobing the words, and then accepting the or rating these hypotheses as the inquiry-based science education. A practice principle, learners need a great deal of practice in a context where they are engaged with the material, not bored with it. And I think that the virtual world is a good idea and a right way. In my research, I have used this sentence. Do not just use technology to seek, read, write, interact, but we need to rethink them in relation to the 3D context. There are other paths in the Unicameral Island, and for example, there is a welcome area. There is a sandbox to work for teachers and students. There are a IPCE pact on earthquake and a pact on natural hazard and the cycle of disaster. Okay, I have finished. Thank you for your attention and for contact. This is my email and the email of Eleonora Paris. And now questions, and I prefer the questions in chat. Thank you, everyone, to be here. Thank you.
So if anyone has a question, please post it into local chat and Lisa or Eleonora will answer your question.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you for your comments.
Not in this moment, there is there isn't access in Hypergrid, but in future, yes. Because now there is an experimentation phase for students and teachers. Now there is teachers, science teachers can log in every day to work in this path. Yes, Nick. You can. Contact me in email. Yes, there are video in YouTube, in my channel. And there are picture and video on Unicamert web site. Thank you, Beth.
I just would like to add the fact that we are translating the activities in English for our foreign students, so it will be possible to make use of the activities and the material.
I am working for this in this period. Thank you, Stephen. Other question? And Kay, Eleonora?
Yes, I think there are some questions regarding the involvement of the students.
Yes, and yes, the students like very much use this environment, this simulation. In fact, they say to teacher to use this environment for other topic, other
activities.
And so I will build other path.
Yeah, the interesting part is also that the teacher seems to be interested very much in this type of activities. Not only the students, which is thinkable that is possible, that is normal for them to use these environments. So. Is something that is spreading and is something that is making even easier to interact between the interaction between the students, the teacher, because they find a common ground to work on and to communicate. So probably is helping not only the contents, the acquisition of contents, but also is helping the acquisition of a better connection between students and teachers.
Yes, I think so. I think this is the solution for communication between teacher and student in the science education, but in the education, in general, in education. The time of any, answer. The time is for the part 1 hour or 2 hours. Depends to for the secondary school or first grade 2 hours. Second grade 1 hour. For building for me 1 week or 2 weeks for part. I think that we can work a good work with 15-20 students. I think, Greta. in the world of the simulation, the simulation are on in this part on eruption, on the silicate minerals, interaction between object with object with the volcanoes. Yes. I work online with the students, but on also in local when in the school there is a connection problem, because in Italy there is this problem in some school or for technical issue, for technical situation, and so they can work online all together or in local host. They prefer work all together in collaboration, the students and the teacher. The teacher work in the environment with the students, write in chat question, for example. Okay. Thank you everyone for question. For other questions, we can send me email for other questions.
Everyone, please give our speakers, and thank you in the audience for listening to a terrific presentation. As a reminder to our audience, you can see what's coming up on the conference schedule at conference.opensimulator.org. The next session in this track will be The Prisoner's Dilemma is Not the Instructor's Dilemma with Kay McLennan at 10 a.m. Thank you again to our speakers and the audience. We'll be back shortly with the next session.